One man back, Crew. Kane takes the shot and scores!
Now Binnington going over to the bench here.
And are we going to have a goaltending change? I believe we are, as the backup goaltender, Ville Husso, is getting set. He's not seated on the bench. There's not enough room on the visitors' bench here at SAP Center for the backup goaltender. So Ville Husso in the tunnel.
Oh, here we
is
go.
Coming back out. Now Binnington getting after it with Dubnyk. As Dubnyk and Binnington come together on Binnington's way off.
Top and add a little chin music on Binnington. Back for Dubois. Now play whistle, and Binnington is going to get called.
Yeah, you know what?
He's tossing the lid.
Pierre-Luc Dubois.
See Binnington score. He fouled Hartman. And the Blues, Binnington coming after him. Hartman skated through Binnington's area and clipped him on the way by in celebration.
And Fleury's over there.
Come
they're
all the
go.
Way down to drop
oh,
the gloves.
My.
But the linesman has a hold of Binnington.
Oh, let him go. Holy jumping.
Marc-Andre Fleury trying to get at him, but the linesman won't let him.
Binnington taking exception after the goal by Hartman. He had a slight bump in. Binnington went at him right away while the Wild were celebrating. Marc-Andre Fleury with no hesitation at all. And Binnington wants this crowd going. Where's Ric Flair?
It is wrestling night here in St. Louis. The crowd is in the mood. Ryan Galloway and David Brisebois, the linesmen, are not. But I feel like this one is far from over.
Hartman does a great job. He strips the puck from Buchnevich, and then he gets the pass back. And now Watts right there. He's celebrating, one knee in the air, and Binnington's out of his grief. Binnington goes right at him and got a... Actually, he got a lot on him. I couldn't see that from...
To the net, and that passed too hard, and then Binnington gave Kane a bit of a shot in the head. And now the Blues to center. They dump it in. That's the second odd man break tonight for Edmonton.
Yeah, Blues got caught there without an F3 to support the pinch. And with a team like the Oilers, if you give them that opportunity, they're going to try and burn you. And then Jordan Binnington taking it into his own hands here to let Evander Kane know that the front of the net is not where he wants him to be.
Yeah, Jamie, he gave him pretty good shot to the face.
Yeah, a little bit of leather in the yap never killed anybody, John. We know that they've got to get things going. And here's the Evander Kane near miss, and then Jordan Binnington, there you go, take that with you, complimentary,
the,
no charge.
The monitor down here between the benches, and wow, that was at Kadri right there. And that was, if he wants to swing, he can, but he gave him a swing and a miss right there.
And then he shot the puck toward Kemper.
Yeah, that's the part that I missed that part.
Right. So he's trying to fire up his team.
All this with a young and inexperienced officiating crew. And here we go with 91 comes over there afterwards. Binnington's not going to...
Russ is working down low, but I don't think Zucker got everything on this shot. I don't know if he was screened by his guy in front, Colby, or not.
I think he was. Krug just steps out on it. But isn't that Brian Rust hanging on to pucks, just eating it down low, guy on his back, not giving it away. And I love that soft spot. And Rust finds Malkin, who finds Zucker.
It wasn't very long, was it?
You called it. He came off his helmet off right away. He knew he was coming out and did a flyby. Oh.
What is going on here?
Takes the helmet off. Look at this. Got the mullet going. This is old time. Old time hockey, Bobby.
This is old school right here.
This guy.
Somebody must have said something. I want to see what happened to Grice.
McDermott put it on. O'Connor a rebound. And it was tied up by Binnington, and he went after O'Connor. Then Tarchenko stepped in with O'Connor. And several others have joined the fray. As a matter of fact, Georgiev has come out to center ice. And the officials are telling him to go back to his goal. Don't even think about crossing that red line.
Yeah, I think that would probably be a good decision for Georgiev to turn away. It's a frustrated Jordan Binnington who's been under siege this afternoon, scoring chance after scoring chance as he calls the crowd on to give it to him a little more.
Is he hurt or just having an equipment problem? Taking advantage of the whistle here. We'll take a break.
Murchison did an excellent job. He followed him all the way to the penalty at the player's bench, and instead of standing in center ice during the stoppage where the linesman normally stand, he was right in his hip pocket the whole time, just there in case something happened. Bit psychologist, bit of a, you know, a guard, but just making sure nothing happens, talking him down, and then he skated back with him all the way to the crease, just trying to make sure, let's keep this game under control.
That's part of the evolution of winning together. That's what happened in 2019 when they started trusting one another. Well, this play here has Binnington a little reluctant to get out of there, shot from a sharp angle. It glanced off of Falk's stick. It wasn't a clean shot on him. I mean, and that's... and Jordan Binnington having some words with the LA Kings bench as he goes by, but